Hello everybody and welcome back to Thornton Farm. We are just heading over to the store to drop off this trailer which I totally forgot to sell last week. I can't believe it. I was trying to concentrate and I thought at the end of the video I must have missed something. And then I watched the video when I was editing it and I thought, no, I don't think I missed anything. And then of course when I uploaded the video, so many people realised that I had not emptied the trailer, which seems pretty obvious now. So that was kind of stupid, so I only can't sell this. And then we're going to move on to the main job of today, which is going to be baling. But you might be thinking, oh no, not that same New Holland baler again. No, we're going to buy a new one. It's going to be a mod. And this is going to be a very good mod. So in a second, we're going to head back to the yard, take the baler to the sell point, and replace it with the new one. So yeah, there are a lot of withered fields about, but it doesn't really matter because they're not ours at the moment. And yeah, we're going to do the green manure when we do buy them, if we buy them. We probably won't be able to buy them all before the end, but I'm hoping to buy a few more. That's the plan. But we've got probably about £1,000 here, maybe two, but it's all extra. The new baler is £55,000, but obviously we can sell the first baler, so we get a bit of money. Wow, that was almost 3,000. Pretty good. And then of course we have got the combine, which does need to be replaced as well. Still planning on doing that, but I don't know. I said in the previous episode that we probably won't use it again. And we might not use it again in the videos. But off screen, I might have to harvest one more field to be able to afford another one. But again, it's only going to be on high purchase, so we're not going to need too much money up front. Obviously we do need a bit, but most of it will be paid as, you know, installments over a number of weeks. So it shouldn't be too long until we have a new combine. And I did say Alexian, but then a lot of people said, oh no, don't keep using class. So, okay, I won't do. We'll move on to a different brand. I was kind of considering a John Deere because they're not really that, well, they're not common where I am. They might be common in other areas of the UK. I know they are used in the UK, so it's definitely realistic to use one. So I think it would be quite a nice brand to go for. But then if I say that, other people might say, oh no, not John Deere, you always use John Deere. So it's hard to win, but you know, I haven't really used many John Deere combines, so I think it will fit in quite well. But here we are, back in the farmyard. And what I want to do really is just drop the trailer off. Need to find a good area for it. We can put it in here. And then I think we'll probably have to transfer over to the John Deere tractor. Not the compact one, obviously, because that is just way too small. The other one, I can't remember. What is it? I always forget John Deere numbers. Sorry to everyone who is a John Deere fan. Well, it's this one over here. It is a lot more powerful, I think, than this tractor. And we're going to tow the baler over to the shop with it. And then hopefully, with a bit of luck, our tractor will be able to power this new baler. Now the new baler is a square baler, I believe. So yeah, they do take more horsepower. It would be nice to be able to keep both, but we do need to get rid of this one, I think, really. At the moment, anyway. We might be able to get another one back in the future. A different one, though, a mod one, because I use way too many of the base game machinery. The oats on the left hand side there already, so it might not be too long until we can harvest those. And when we come up here, we do need to also bring back the quad bike because I've left that at the shop and it is a bit, it doesn't really want to be left there, so we'll bring it back today. And there's the field we're going to bale, and we better not crash. Okay, so here we are. Let's just indicate into here. And we need to put the baler in the cell box here. I still don't really know why the bale is there. I think it's probably because I sold the baler, the other one. And there must have been one still in there. That is the only reason I can think of it being there. Right, there we go. Hopefully it doesn't pick up the quad bike as the machine we want to sell. No, actually that is pretty good. £34,800. That does seem good. Oh yeah, the notes. It's the same key. Right, so we have £95,000. Like I say, the baler is 55. So we should be okay here. It's the Quadrant 3200 by Black Sheep, same as the Massey Ferguson one which we've been using. But I haven't really used too much class stuff of the Baylor's. I know it is another class machine, but it's not a combine, and I've never used this mod before. So I do think it'd be quite nice to use it. Let's just attach it. And I think before we go anywhere, I will just start it up, run the PTO up, and make sure it can actually power it. It's going to be on its limit, I think. But what a good looking baler that is. Right, it can turn it on, that's a good start. But can it move? That is not too good. Okay, it can do 3 miles per hour. 3. Are we going to max out at 3? Oh no, 4. Okay, so I think realistically this tractor is a bit too small for the baler. Again, we could go for another higher purchase, but then we're going to be paying so much back every week. This is something I can do, but it's going to be costly. So, okay, which tractor? We can actually rent, but then, I don't know, it might be not as cost effective doing it that way. I've got a lot of machines here. Some of them I can't use because they're private, but others I can. So, what shall we go for? There are some I'd love to use, but I just can't do. We could go for a... I suppose we could go for New Holland, but I use them quite a bit as well. Actually, I don't usually use T7s, actually, so that might not be a bad idea. A T7. I think I might do, actually. If we rent the T7-270, that might be a good one to go for. And this is the one with the power command transmission. So, oh yeah, this looks good. I think we'll go for this. Let's just rent it for one day and see how much it would cost. Okay, that's expensive. That is expensive. But, yeah, I don't really know another great solution to that. We're going to have it for 24 hours. And, like I say, we're playing real time. So, that's going to be at least 6 hours of gameplay. At least, because I skipped night time. We're going to have to bring everything back, though. Because we've now got, well, three machines here, all of which need to go back to the yard. But yeah, this is a tractor which I don't usually use, and it should be powerful enough to run this baler. Let's just take a look. I'm always being told to use more New Holland, so hopefully I can't go wrong here. Right, let's unfold it again. It seems like quite a beastie tractor. Yeah, much better. Still not perfect, but balers are powerful things, so they do require quite a bit of power. Yes, that sounded weird. Balers are powerful things, so they require a lot of power, obviously. Right, let's just get this on to follow me, and then we'll head back to the yard. And the quad bike as well. Put that on follow me. And now into the lead tractor. Hopefully we don't get crashed into too much. And the plan is to finish off that field today. Well, actually, we haven't even started it. The plan is to completely do that field today. It's not a very big field, but it's a bit messy again because we use quite a small combine, so it does make it harder when baling. But I think using the windrower to row up in that field might do more harm than good because it's so narrow between those trees. I'm just going to make a big mess, so probably best not to. Right, how are we doing? We've got anyone following us? Do we? We don't. Everyone has stopped. There is a reason why everyone has stopped. Yep. So how far did it make it? What's this, about, well, 50 yards maximum? Oh no, we didn't even come out. Hang on, we came out of here. Ah, oh, I see what's going on here. It must have pulled out in front of a car. You fool! You've just killed yourself. That is not good. I think I'm going to have to reset that. Right then, so the quad bike is reset. It should be at the yard. Did not go well. We're taking the tractor back with the John Deere following us. And then we'll head back to the field. I don't really want the John Deere just sitting in the field with us because it'd probably get in the way. If we slow down a bit, then it won't take the turn so tight or so fast. Okay, so you stop there. It likes to go at some speed. Turn it off, and we'll head up to field number 4. And yeah, if we can get that all done today, that'd be brilliant. And this honestly is the first time I've ever used this baler, so I don't really know what to expect. I kind of do actually, because I know that Black Sheep's mods are just fantastic. The detailing is very good, so I would be very disappointed if I hit a glitch, and I don't think I will do. So I've got very high hopes for this mod. I've just had to restart the game because I got that funny glitch again where the time disappears and it starts to go laggy. I had that before on Gold Edition, and I kind of did establish what the problem was, but I don't have that mod running on this map, so I don't know. I don't know why it did it. It's never done it before on here, but it seems to be sorted now, so that's all good. Right, so let's begin. Let's unfold the baler, and let's put the pickup down. And this should work quite well. We should get this done relatively quickly. But that's the plan anyway. And I'm actually looking forward to seeing the first bale, because if you look down the bottom right hand corner, I think it's actually recognised that this is oat straw and not straw from wheat or barley. So it might be a different texture, I'm not too sure. The straw which is on the ground is obviously exactly the same, but the baler does seem to be recognising it as something different. So it might be a lighter colour. I can just about see it coming out the back here. But if you want to download this mod, I'll put the link below. It's definitely worth giving it a go. I can already see it's going to be fantastic. And this tractor has picked up speed, so it doesn't really have any issues with pulling it. But it looks like this baler does want about 280 horsepower. As does any big square baler. Right, so I'm hoping that doing the headlands first isn't going to make us put the bales in the way of when we're going up and down the field. Hopefully not. There's the first bale. It's actually on the second bale now, but obviously it's still pushing out the back. And yeah, it looks pretty good. Now these bales we're going to have to keep, I think, just for the time being, because I don't know exactly what we're going to do with them. If I can't find a use for them, we'll sell them, but I don't want to just rush into it. We might sell a few loads, but we definitely need to keep some. Right, when that one comes out the back, I'm going to go in cab view again. There we go. The reason for that is because going around here, it can be quite easy to miss bits, and I don't want to. But it certainly seems to be performing very well. Class equipment always is good, that's why I use it, but yeah, you can have too much of one brand, I think. While we're talking about different brands, I think it might be a good idea just to touch on the Southwest Norway map, and I think overall the response from the machinery which I downloaded for that map has gone down quite well. There's a few people who aren't quite happy with it, but on the whole it seems to be pretty good. Now, in response to this video, it'd be brilliant if you can say before I record the next video for Southwest Norway, is everybody happy with the Merlot? Because I love that Merlot, but apparently I use it too often, so is there any other machine you would like me to use instead, like maybe a JCB? I can't say I'll be able to get it straight into the map for the next episode, but I can certainly consider it for the future. It's just there were a few people who were saying the Merlot was overused, so let me know your opinion on that. Do you want me to keep it or shall we change it? So when we finish this job, we're going to have to do the pigs like I said last week, but obviously we need the money to do the pigs. I think we do, because they're not very expensive, so £23,000 is going to be plenty, and we'll still have a lot left over. I can't remember how much they are exactly, about £300? £50, wow. Okay, yeah, we don't need much money at all. So we'll do the pigs tomorrow. I think that'd be the best thing to do. But yeah, the priority today is to get this belt. The reason behind that is because if you've got soil mod running, if you leave straw or grass in a field for too long, it will actually disappear. So we've got to get this baled, otherwise we're just going to lose it all, which would be not very good. Obviously that would be a total waste, so just got to keep going. And it means I have a good excuse to rent a different machine. We get to use the New Holland today. Love the physics on this tractor. I think it's the Real Terrain mod which I've got running, but the way that it's making the tractor respond to the ground is just fantastic. If only this was implemented into Farming Simulator as standard. Maybe it will be. I don't know for sure, but it definitely makes it a drastic improvement to the physics of the game. Right, so that is 13 bales. We're doing pretty well. And obviously we've still got about half the field left to do. So yeah, it's pretty good. It might end up to be about maybe about 25 bales actually, because I have done a bit up there. So yeah, between 20 and 25 bales I'd be very happy with. And these trees we have towering above us are going to be left. I think we might even plant the field again. You would tend to have more than 1 year between planting a tree and harvesting it. It would usually, what would it be, about 20, 30 years? Not too sure really. It would depend on the type of tree. These are pine trees, I believe, so yeah, they're fir trees. So yeah, it's going to be 20 or 30 years, I would say. Anyway, I think this is probably going to be a good time to say, basically, in real life and on my YouTube channel, I'm about to become very busy. I've got a lot of videos to produce, and also I've, in real life, got a lot of other stuff to do as well. So don't be surprised if I come off my schedule just for a day. Like, there might be a day where it should be Thornton Farm, but it ends up being something else. That's just because I'm either really busy with another video producing that, or in real life I haven't really had time to think about what to do in this series, so I have to just go and do another video instead. So yeah, basically just an early warning, there won't be a day missed without a video, I'm sure, but it might not be the video that you're expecting. So just something I want to say really, but hopefully there won't really be any impact at all. It should be pretty seamless, but yeah, I'm pretty busy at the moment, so yeah, it's going to be quite hard to keep up with things. But a video a day is my goal, and if I miss a video a day, then I won't be happy. That is something I love to do every day. Alright, so we've got 5 swaths left to do, I think. Maybe a bit there. I'll have to go back for that bit there. So 5 in a bit, and we're on 19 bales. Pretty good. So this is going all to plan. This is very good indeed. Yeah, hoping the crop which has been missed, which I can't get to, is going to just wither and die off. That would be the best thing. It should do. And then we'll be able to cultivate and obviously reseed. So it seems that the agroforestry field has actually gone down quite well. A lot of other people who have been watching this video have said, oh, I fancy doing that, I'm going to do that in my game. Which is great, I love to see that, because obviously it means that these videos are giving people inspiration. If you don't like it, fair enough, everyone has their own way of doing things. It's just something I've thought of doing before. I have done it before on Cobra Park Farm, or just Cobra Farm. Yes, it was just Cobra Farm. And yeah, it went down well there. I had Chainsaw 100 helping me, and it was a lot better because we did the measurements properly. On here, not quite so well, admittedly, but it still worked. It still worked okay. So it isn't a bad thing to do. Right, we are on 23 bales, I think. It will be. And then that'll be the field completed. Right, so we're on 87%. If we just get this bit here we've missed, then it should push us up to roughly 100%, hopefully. If not, I'll just have to keep going round and round, picking up bits and bobs. until we hit 100. And it looks like we're going to have to. Okay, we're on 99%. Almost there. Come on, please hit 100. Really? Is that... That's four something off. What is that? Four stalks of straw. Off a bale. Well, there should be more than four stalks here. It could be litres. I think it's litres. That was two. Okay, that was two. This bit here. We're going to get there. There we go. Brilliant. Okay. So that is that done. We should be able to empty it. There we go. We won't put them all together. Fantastic. And that was 25 bales. So that was the best of what I thought it was going to be. 20 to 25, and we got 25. Fantastic. So, let's take this back to the yard. We're going to have to try and use this tractor a bit more now because it's obviously rented. We are paying for every second we have it. And it actually won't be a bad idea to shut these gates as well, because we're not going to be coming back in here for a couple of episodes. I wouldn't have thought, unless I do decide to pick them up before we do the pigs, but I wouldn't have thought so. Right, off we go. But I've got to say, very nice tractor and a very nice baler. It's a pretty good setup, really. It might be better if we go around the back of here because there's a lot more space. Yeah, just in here should be fine. So yeah, like I say, tomorrow we'll be doing the pigs, and I'm looking forward to doing it because I haven't done them for a while. And it's really just going to be a case of tending to them, making sure they've got everything they need. And then we'll be able to pick the bales up. But that is it for this episode. Hopefully you've enjoyed the video. And until next time, see you again soon. Bye for now.